The 400-plus page report details the offenses that forced former Cardinal Theodore McCarrick to give up his red hat and Roman collar.
Nothing like this has happened before in the history of the church, where there's such an intensive investigation into the misdeeds of someone who was once a cardinal.
Once the face of the U.S. Catholic Church's response to the sex abuse crisis, the news in 2018 that McCarrick had abused an altar boy decades before released a torrent of revelations. His former diocese of Metuchen in Newark, New Jersey, revealed settlements in 2005 and 2007 with former seminarians accusing McCarrick of sexual misconduct. A family friend, James Grine, said McCarrick repeatedly abused him starting at age 11.
He forced himself on me. And it was always that left hand saying, "Don't you know how powerful I am?"
Then the Vatican's former U.S. ambassador accused Pope Francis and other Vatican officials of covering up McCarrick's misdeeds, charges Francis denied, telling Mexican TV he had no idea about McCarrick's past. Now 90, McCarrick denied the altar boy's claim and has not commented on other accusations. The report identifies red flags and warnings raised in the 1990s, including accusations of sharing beds with young men studying to be priests at a New Jersey beach house, sex with a priest, and anonymous letters accusing McCarrick of pedophilia with his so-called nephews. An investigation at the request of Pope John Paul II found only that McCarrick had shared a bed and no sexual misconduct. McCarrick insisted he had never had sexual relations. The report says the investigation had inaccurate and incomplete information, and John Paul made McCarrick Archbishop of Washington and then Cardinal. Under Pope Benedict XVI, there was an unsuccessful attempt to restrict the now retired Cardinal's public life, but no formal investigation. And the report says Francis was not provided with the allegations against McCarrick when he became Pope.
In the report, Francis, like many, told investigators he had heard the rumors and accusations regarding McCarrick's conduct, but he thought they had been addressed by his predecessors.